There are so many AI art generators out there, and it's really hard to decide which one is best for logo design. That's why in this video, we're gonna compare them all. So as you can see, here we have 6 generations. We're gonna use this prompt to make a comparison fair. Simple flat vector logo of a lion on a white background. Now let's start with Midjourney. Here are some of my previous generations, but basically, you're gonna start by typing /imagine, and then you can copy paste my prompt from the description below. And there you go. Only after a few seconds, we can start seeing the results. And the results are pretty great in the sense that it actually listens. We have a white background. The generations are pretty good and usable. They do look like logos, not like illustrations. They are simple. We can upscale the logo. I really like the second one. But now we can copy this image. We can take this to Illustrator and vectorize this, add the text, and voila, we have a logo. Okay, so the next one is Adobe Firefly. Here are my previous generations, so let's run this prompt again. I'm gonna hit refresh. And there you go, it only took a few seconds, although the generations are not that great in the sense that the background is not actually white. It's some great background with some slight gradient. And there are some slight gradients in the logos themselves, and they look more like illustrations, not logos. Maybe besides the first one. The first one is probably the best. So again, you can download this image and you can work with that image in Illustrator. Just to note something, this is the Firefly Image 2 model, which is way better than the previous one. It was just released recently. So make sure you're using this one. And by the way, you have a lot of control over your images right now. You can play with these settings and especially with this match. If you like certain logos and certain styles, you can upload those logos right here and try to imitate that style. Or you can just go to this reference gallery, scroll all the way to the bottom. So let's try this one. And there you go. As you can see, it's ready to apply this style. So again, you can experiment with other styles and techniques, and you can upload your own images. I think this is pretty good for logo design if you want to achieve specific style. Okay, so the next on our list is the new Dall-e 3. The way you use that is you just go to a new chat and you select Dall-e 3, and here are my previous generations, and as you can see, they're pretty good. This one is quite interesting, very geometric, symmetric, and stuff like that. So let's just paste the prompt and let's run this again. There you go, we have totally different results this time. But what's great about Dall-e is that you can follow up and you can say, for example, I like the second logo, please zoom in on the lion's head. And there you go, it says that it zoomed in on the lion's head, although it misses. Sometimes it follows your prompt, sometimes it seems like it doesn't. It's probably still in beta. But what's great about that, you can always follow up and you can experiment. The next one on my list is Leonardo AI. And here are my previous generations. And basically, you have a lot of different engines that you can experiment with. So we are using the SDXL 0.9. And then you just paste your prompt right here. So let's run this again. And there you go. This time the results are pretty different. Although they're all faced the right side and we only have a head of a lion. You have a lot of control over the images. You can change the ratio. You can make like an image prompt. You can find a great logo that you like. I think it's a great tool for logo design as well. Now the next one is Ideogram. And it has some generations right here. This is what I was able to achieve earlier. So let's run this prompt again. Now something to note with Ideogram that it actually takes much longer than other AI art generators. And there you go, we are starting to see some generations right here. They are quite different. We have the whole lion, we have just the lion's head, and we have a more like a cartoonish version. But what's good about Ideogram, that you can say with text Lion King, for example, and regenerate that. So you can actually generate logos with text, which you cannot do using Midjourney. You can only do it using Ideogram or Dall-e 3. And as you can see, the text is perfect. for the most part, right? Here you would have to fix it, but other than that, you can rerun this prompt and you have it with matching text, which I think is pretty great. And now the last tool is from Google, which some of you might be actually unfamiliar with. So basically you can just say create and then paste your prompt. And as long as you have this generative AI turned on, it's gonna create images right here in the Google search results, as you can see. So let's rerun this prompt actually one more time. And there you go, this time we only have two generations, but they are very simple. They are pretty much usable as logo, especially this one. I think it looks something like Puma logo, I would say. They all have different options and they give you different results. Just something to remember, with Dall-e 3 and with Ideogram, you can actually generate logos with text, and other tools won't let you do the text. And watch my other videos to learn how to vectorize those logos, either in Illustrator or using some free online tools. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video.